Hey fellow animators, I'm Miloš Černý, and today I'm going to continue with weighting vertices of this quadruped creature model to the rig we created in a previous part of this tutorial, in a process called skinning. As I said in previous video also, the model is free to download, created by the artist Shiva3D and available on TurboSquid. There is a link below the video if you want to download it. Okay, so let's continue exactly where we finished in the last part. Select the model and apply skin modifier to it. Click on Add Bones button and add everything except the platforms and the cat parent triangle. Because they are not bones, just helpers, and we don't want them to be affecting the model. You can create a motion layer to test the skin with the default animation. We see that the eyes are not moving with the model, because they are a separate object, so apply skin modifier to them as well. And add just eye bone for each of them, because we don't want them to be affected by any other bone. When applying skin modifier, do it with the animation mode turned off, so the model is in its default position. When we created the rig, we did all of the additional bones for head as a children of the head bone, which means that now when we rotate the eyelids are not moving with it. We can change that by simply linking the eyelid bones to the eye. You can test out the skin, because after applying the skin modifier and adding bones, Max applied some default values to the vertices taken from the position and size of the bones. But you can see a lot of changes and tweaking is required. Before you start fixing them, you should always create a testing animation, which is basically in ideal situation every possible movement of every single bone. They are quite boring to make, but you have to do it. So here is mine. It's not perfect, but you can always add animations if you are missing something during skinning. Now set up bone effect limit to 4, which is always enough for skinning, and it prevents some unexpected behavior when importing models to game engines, which are usually limited to 4 bones per vertex as well. You can see that I have removed eye bones from skinning modifier because I thought I will not need them for the main mesh. But later in the process, I added them back after I realized they will be useful for eye sockets vertices inside the model, so you don't have to remove them at all. Apply simple gray texture to the model, so we can see the value colors better. And let's start skinning. There are a lot of approaches to this, and different people do it in different ways. So I will show you how I am doing this, but if you are used to something else, do it the way you like. Important is the result, not the way of doing it. Me personally, I mostly use weight tool and apply weights with numbers. You can play with envelopes and do a big part of skinning with them and then just fix the problematic parts with numbers. Or you can just paint the values with brush tool. Anything what works for you. Now, I will not be explaining every single step I am doing, because that would take like 5 hours. But generally, I start by applying 100% value to the vertices that are affected by just that one bone. Like here, we started with ankle and worked towards the area of the joint. The area where two bones meet, the best values are usually 50-50. And then some easing for the edges around them. Use loop and ring buttons, so you don't have to select all the vertices manually all the time. Also, skin just one side of the model, because after you are done with it, you will mirror all the weights to the other side. Another thing to keep in mind when skinning, you always work with adding the values, not removing them. When you think about it, weight values of a vertex are distributed to the maximum of 4 bones. So let's say you set up a value for bone 1 to 100%. It means that the bone 2, 3 and 4 will have value of 0%. But after that, if you change the value of 100% to 40%, where will the other 60% go? Because they have to be used somewhere. What will happen is that the value will be spread between bones 2, 3 and 4. But that might not be the wanted result. Maybe you need for bone 4 to have 0% weight. So you would have to select the bone 4 and fix it. If you work with adding values, you will not get that unexpected result where vertex is influenced by bone you didn't even want it. But it is just about knowing what is going on. Sometimes it is even useful to subtract values instead of adding them. But the point is, you should always know what you are doing and how the software interprets it. I will skip some parts so the video is not too long, But the process of skinning is mostly about doing the same thing over and over, just for different parts. Of course, it needs a lot of practicing as well. Some areas where multiple bones meet are quite hard to skin, and often it is about trying out different things and different values and see what works and what doesn't.
Thank you.
When you think you are done with skinning, you can try out some poses to see if you are able to get them. For example, here I am trying if he is able to eat from the ground, meaning that the mouth can touch the ground and still look okay. But it seems fine. Last thing is mirroring the weights to the other side. So, first turn off the animation mode to be in a default position. And select mirror mode. Then you have four options for mirroring. What we need is to paste vertices from the blue bones to the green ones. So hit that, and you can see that the leg changed immediately. And so did the rest of the vertices. Now we can consider this done. Apply the texture back and you can start to animate. But keep in mind that later during animation you can always find some parts that aren't skinned well or don't work as you want it. That is pretty common. You can stop animating, fix the skin and get back to animation again. So that's it. Full quadruped rig, ready for animation. If you have some questions, leave a comment below and see you in the next video. I am Miloš Černý and thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe if you like my videos. My website is coming along nicely and hopefully I will be able to launch it soon. In the meantime, like, comment and share. Thank you.